So today we are going to ask some questions about the role play. So what do you think role play is?
So role playing is defined as an act where a child engages in a number of makeup scenarios or imaginary scenarios whereby they make use of new vocabulary and vocabulary structures that they learned in their English class. It's a very creative way of engaging with the English language and having fun with it, especially for children who are younger and want to have fun with engaging with the English language. So in each situation, children must observe, focus on listening, and selectively respond as the character that is being played. So they take on a new persona, they engage with the character, and they don't respond or listen to their partner as themselves. They respond as if they were someone else, as a different character or a new character. They learn how to use the language at the right time. They learn when it is okay to say this, and when it is okay to say that, and when they should say this instead. What is the polite way of speaking English in this situation, and what is the colloquial way of speaking English in that situation? And it prepares them for real life situations where they learn how and when to use English correctly.
So it's a good way of learning English.
Definitely.
What do you think the role play had during learning as well?
I think that some of the different methods that we can use are developments of listening skills. So children try to understand the information that their partner is conveying to them and listen and take it in. Sometimes if you focus on parrot learning fashion, where you say a word and the child repeats, they're listening but they're not understanding the word. They're simply repeating what you're saying without any deeper level of understanding. Whereas with role playing, they're listening to the word and they have to take it in order to come up with a valid response to give to their partners. So that's one way of looking at it in terms of developing listening skills. And as a result, we develop our speaking skills. When you're listening and understanding what someone is saying, you're able to formulate a response and then speak as a result. So we're looking at different ways that we can respond to situations. If someone says, "Hello, how are you?" the child would then interpret this greeting and respond, "I'm fine, thank you, how are you?" Or, "I'm hungry," as my children always tell me. "I'm hungry, teacher." That kind of response gets a conversation going, and then my children say, "I have not eaten," or "I'm fighting with Ling in class." And that kind of response allows for conversation that then encourages your students to dig deeper within the English language and then creates a whole dialogue between either the teacher or the partner, etc. Another method is raising awareness. So during role-playing processes, the child must communicate the information from his or her partner. So they must be able to, like I said before, really understand the deeper meaning of English and then be able to formulate and speak a response based on what their partner has said. So it's no use in creating a role-playing environment that the partners don't have a connection with. You can't have one person saying, "I like tigers," and the other person saying, "I'm fine, thank you, how are you?" Because there is no correlation. Whereas with role playing, we encourage the students to create a conversation that can link into each other. "I like lions." "Oh, I don't like lions. I like elephants." Yeah. Creating a relatable conversation. Number four, we like to accelerate language proficiency. So it's an ideal way when using role play for children to reinvent all that they've learned, all the vocabulary and structures that they've learned in class, the boring things, and to create a fun kind of way in order to express themselves using this new knowledge that they've gained. And the last one is that it develops our social skills. Children are very susceptible to learning new languages, their brains are easily molded by the subjects that we teach them. But sometimes we find that children don't always know how to interact with one another or how to interact with grown-ups and other adults or people from all over. So by using role play, we can encourage that social development. How do you interact with someone when you meet someone on the street, when you go to the shops and you buy food? How do you interact with them? You don't just go and you buy food and then you leave. We communicate, and that's the basis of human nature, is communication. So being able to communicate properly and in a way that you're able to express yourself and your needs and your wants to another human being is something that's very important when learning a new language.
Mm-hmm.